Today we are going to discuss the functional antagonism or physiological antagonism. So what is this functional or physiological antagonism? When two drugs acts on two different receptors but on the same physiological system, they will produce opposite effects. By definition, when two drugs acts on two different receptors but on the same physiological system, they will produce opposite effects. For example, here insulin and glucagon. Insulin is secreted by the beta cells of the pancreas, glucagon secreted by the alpha cells of the pancreas. They will act on two different receptors. Here two drugs like insulin and glucagon. Insulin act on the insulin receptors, which are the specific type of receptors which are present on the beta cells of the pancreas. Glucagon, they will act on the glucagon receptors. That means two drugs, they will act on two different receptors but on the same physiological system, like they will going to act on the blood glucose level or blood sugar level. And we know that what is the function of insulin? It will reduce or decrease the blood glucose level. That means it causes hypoglycemia. And glucagon, it will going to act on the glucagon receptors and there will be increase in the blood glucose level. So what is functional or physiological antagonism? When two drugs like insulin and glucagon, they will act on two different receptors like insulin receptors and glucagon receptors, but on the same physiological system like blood glucose, it will produce, insulin will produce hypoglycemia and glucagon will produce hyperglycemia. We'll take one more example of this. Histamine and adrenaline. These are the two different drugs. Histamine will act on the histaminergic receptors like H1. Adrenaline acts on adrenergic receptors like beta-2 and on the same physiological system like bronchial smooth muscles. If histamine will act on the bronchial smooth muscle, it will cause bronchoconstriction. If adrenaline will act on the bronchial smooth muscles, there are beta-2 receptors in the bronchial smooth muscle, so it will cause bronchodilatation. Means two drugs, they will act on two different receptors, but on the same physiological system, it will produce opposite effect. That's why here you can see adrenaline is a drug of choice in the anaphylactic shock. Why adrenaline is a drug of choice in case of anaphylactic shock? Because in anaphylactic shock, the causative agent is the histamine, and for the histamine which causes bronchoconstriction, we have to give adrenaline as a drug of choice because it causes bronchodilatation by acting on the same physiological system.